thanks to Exter for making this video possible. China is facing its worst drought in nearly a century. The country's largest reservoirs are drying up, and it's facing severe water shortages. To combat this ongoing problem, the Chinese government has outlined a $60 billion plan to drastically change the distribution of water across the country, from the humid south to the drier north. But all of this raises the question, how will this plan impact China's water crisis, and what are the long-term effects of this massive project? To answer this, we need to better understand the key causes of the country's water crisis. Roughly 62% of China's water goes toward the agriculture industry, which has led to overuse of the country's water supply. The combination of overextraction and inefficient use of water has resulted in serious shortages in some parts of the country. In addition to these challenges, China is currently facing its worst drought in more than 60 years, adding to a long list of challenges already affecting the country's water supply system. Besides overuse of the water resources, another challenge is the location of dams and reservoirs throughout the country. The majority of China's water resources are concentrated in the south, which has put severe strain on northern parts of the country. While China as a whole does have a significant supply of water, its uneven distribution is the key cause of the water crisis. If we take a look at a map comparing the population versus water resources, we see how this problem becomes apparent. While northern China accounts for 46% of the country's population, it holds roughly 20% of the water supply resources. This is in comparison to the south, which accounts for 54% of the country's population and holds more than 80% of the water supply. The distribution of the country's water also corresponds with the location of the population, with close to 90% living in north or eastern parts of the country. Because of this, the distribution of water has become a major problem, and a solution seemed to be quite complex. But this is where the Chinese government has made an ambitious proposal. What if water from the humid south could be transferred to the drought-plagued north? This has been the question for more than 50 years, but the country's South-North Water Transfer Project aims to do just that. The project intends on using three separate transport routes, all intended on transferring water towards northern China. The eastern route of the project will span over 1,200 kilometers and transfer water from the Yangtze River in the south to the Yellow River in the north. The middle route of the project will span just over 800 kilometers and mainly consist of a canal system and multiple reservoirs. It's intended to transfer water from the Han River in the south to the Hai River in the north. And finally, the western route of the project, which plans to connect the Yangtze and Yellow Rivers to divert more than 600 billion gallons of water. This is by far the most expensive part of the water transfer, mainly due to the complexity involved in its design. All three of these routes will work together to create an efficient water transfer and meet the needs of northern China. But despite the promises set forward by the Chinese government, there have been a number of controversial aspects behind this project. While there are multiple factors driving the controversy behind this development, one of the key components is the cost. Critics have argued against the Chinese government's plans to invest so much money into this project, stating that it could have been better spent solving the root causes of the water crisis. For example, critics have stated that the money could have been spent on improving existing water supply infrastructure and implementing better water management practices. This would then reduce the need for such a large-scale water transfer project. Furthermore, it would help promote sustainable development and agriculture in the north, ultimately decreasing the amount of water being used. In addition to these factors, the environmental impacts of constructing such a large project have caused disagreement with the intentions of this development. While the project plans to benefit the environment in the long term, constructing this development may cause severe damage by itself. And while the cost of this development has caused disagreement, one of the most controversial parts has to do with the western route of the project. This route intends on mainly using a series of large tunnels including a main tunnel stretching over 1,000 kilometers long. The route will also require a number of new reservoirs and canals to merge the two major rivers together. As a result of all of this, the project will have severe environmental impacts. This has again caused widespread disagreement, but it has ultimately not made a difference. The Chinese government has stated that they will move forward with constructing this project, despite the widespread backlash. This route of the project alone is expected to cost over $36 billion and not be completed until 2050. But despite the widespread backlash behind this development, the Chinese government has stated that they will prioritize conservation in this development. While these efforts have yet to be seen with this development, the Chinese government believes that the project's environmental impacts will be minimal. With China experiencing its worst drought in 60 years, this project may prove to be extremely beneficial for the country. By using satellite imagery, we can better understand the extensive drought China experienced in 2022, and the long-term effects it may have on the country. In just 1 year, China's Poyang Lake lost 75% of its water supply, causing farmers to struggle all across the region. And unfortunately, this has been the case all across the country. In order to put an end to China's water crisis, this project may be the only solution in the long term. According to a report from December of 2022, the project has already benefited more than 150 million people across the country. While this is a small step in solving a larger problem, it proves that the project is on the right path to have a successful future ahead. China's South-North Water Transfer Project is truly one of the most ambitious engineering projects in history. While the development has faced numerous controversies, the benefits may outweigh the risks and secure a strong future for one of the largest countries in the world. Today, the eastern and middle routes of the project are in full operation, as the western route continues to be constructed. If progress continues at a steady pace, the effects of this project could be seen in the near future. The effects of China's water crisis have been widespread and highlight the importance of protecting your personal belongings in difficult situations. With Extra's smart wallets, this process is simple and efficient. One of my favorites is the aluminum card holder, which allows you to access all of your cards with the click of a button. There is also no threat of losing your wallet. The tracker card allows you to keep an eye on your belongings at all times. No matter which style you have in mind, Extra's wide range of products has you covered. For up to 35% off a smart wallet today, visit shop.extra.com/archive and use code archive at checkout.